Very good afternoon to all of you. It's my immense pleasure to welcome you all in the first class of class 12. I know this very well that yesterday only we have completed the major test, and suddenly from today we are starting our new session. But don't worry, we are not going to start any lecture today. Today you can enjoy your one day holiday. From tomorrow itself we are going to start our classes. Now, why I am today in front of you? See students, 1 year has gone, okay, and now from 11th standard you all are moving to class 12. So before we start our class 12th session, this is my responsibility to make you aware, okay, about some good things, okay, some bad things, in what way we have to prepare for 12th standard, in what way we have to, or what should be our strategy for this 1 year, okay. So fine, this session is going to be informative session for you. Whatever mistakes you did in the last year, these mistakes you are not going to repeat. If you have not studied well, in what way you can plan for this year so that you can cover whole NEET syllabus. So with this positive attitude we are going to start this year, okay. We are going to utilize each and every second of this year, fine. So let's start, okay. Now the aim of this, or the motive of this lecture, that as we all are moving from 11th to 12th standard, officially we are moving into 12th standard, the first question which is there in everyone's mind, I know that, okay, everyone has this question in his mind, that or do you think that you have not studied enough in class 11th, okay. So this is a very common question, as you have given so many exams, okay, so many tests also we have conducted. So the question which is in your mind, that what I'm asking, that do you think that you have studied enough? Do you think that you have studied enough in class 11? Okay, very important question. I know everyone has this question in mind. Do you feel that you have studied enough up to the mark which is required for NEET preparation? Yes, sir. I know obviously the answer is no. Yes, sir. According to me, according to you also, because the last year when we started our class 11th in 2020, already lockdown was going on everywhere. The situation is of pandemic. We started online classes. Okay, you were not aware about the study pattern, in what way you have to start. We started the offline lecture, you were not able to cope up with that backlogs, okay. So obviously the answer of this question is no, okay, you have not studied enough, okay, with respect to NEET point of view. So are you worried that this might get in the way of scoring good score in the NEET exam? Say definitely it is going to hamper your NEET score, because we know that class 11 syllabus plays major role, okay. The weightage of class 11, it has all basic concepts, or it has basic lessons, so that you have to revise properly. Okay, so this is a thing that you have to think about it. So in what way we can get the solution at this? The first thing, don't worry. Instead of thinking what is gone, okay, think what is there in front of you. I know 1 year is gone, but still one whole year is there in front of you. There is very famous story, if you have a glass in front of you which is half filled, it depends upon the person thinking. If you are thinking half glass is empty, someone may think half glass is full. So we also have to have the positive attitude. 1 year has gone, fine, means you have not lost anything. Still 1 year is there. Although you start your study from today itself, believe me, in 1 year you can complete study of 11th as well as 12th. I have seen so many students, okay, they don't play much attention in class 11th, or they are not serious in class 11th. Somewhere near the end of 12th standard or half year of 12th standard, they realize, okay, they start their study according to plan, okay, they utilize each and every moment, okay, and they give their best performance. So you can also do this, but for this you should be strict to some things, okay. So these things I'm going to discuss today, in what way you can cover up your studies, okay. Definitely this is a problem for everyone. Every child in this nation is facing the same problem, okay, so we have to come up with some solutions so that you can revise your class 11th and class 12th, both the things. So don't worry, as I told you, what is gone, instead of that you have one whole year in front of you. So we will make a plan for that, how you can utilize that or simply how we can use this time to cope up with this. Now 2020, we know that it went in the pandemic conditions, online teaching, everything, blah blah blah. You took some time to adjust yourself, okay, but fine, now you know what is the pattern of study. So although you are at home, you should be stuck to your timetable, okay. According to timetable you have to study, so that not a single minute should get wasted. Fine. Now some things that we are going to discuss. Although we are going to start the class 12th online for some days, if possible we will try to start the school offline, because it is very important. There are some lessons which are to be taught in the class itself, like there is genetics, there is small bio, biotechnology. These lessons are very important lessons, as I am discussing for the biology. For other subjects also there are some lessons. For this, offline teaching is very important. So although we started online, you have to give your full potential. You have to observe all these lectures properly, note down all your notes, okay. Already now you know what is the strategy of study. After completion of lesson you have to go for the revision, you have to solve the MCQs. Now you will be provided with the modules, as you know that we are going to provide you the module, but still you are at home, we will send you the PDF of those specific lesson that we are going to start. As soon as you will come in the school, you can take the hard copy of that module. So you have to go through every concept of that module. Questions which are given in the modules also you have to study, okay. Now this 1 year, how we are going to use, so what will be our strategy, okay. What will be the strategy for this 2021? Okay, 2021 and 2022, in that you are going to give your NEET examination. As I told you, what is gone, that is not important. What is there in front of you, that is important. So 1 year we are going to utilize properly. So this 1 year is going to be most productive for you. Okay, so you have to use this 1 year in the most productive way. What can we do for that? Never waste time, okay. Do not waste your time. So we are going to make it most productive year, okay. It should be most productive year. You have to utilize your full energy for this. Don't waste time. Don't waste your time. Yes, do not waste your time. Single minute is also important for you. Fine. Then study from day one. Study from day one. Don't think that yesterday only we completed our major test and suddenly we have to start class 12. No. 2 years you are going to spend for NEET examination. There is no gap in between. So day one, okay, it is equally important. You have to start your studies from day one, okay. So study from day one of class 12 till the last day, or means on till the exam day. So whenever your exam will be there, till that, okay, you have to continue your study and utilize every moment to its fullest, okay. Just forget, you will not get this chance again, and you have to give your best performance in the first chance itself, okay. So utilize every moment. to its fullest. So these things you have to remember, okay? Don't waste your time, don't be relaxed, okay? You will be relaxed only after your NEET examination. Till that, you are not allowed to be relaxed, okay? Because if you have set your goal, if you have set your target that you want to go above 600, above 650, then this much you have to do, okay? Whatever is gone, don't think about that, because that is not in your hand, not in our hand. But what is there in front of us, we can utilize that, and we can cover up 11th as well as 12th standard syllabus properly in that. So just keep this positive attitude, okay, and give your best performance in this 1 year, fine. Now, as I told you, 1 year is enough to cover class 11th and class 12th syllabus, okay? So for that, what is required, or how we can utilize, why, or how this 1 year we can use? So for that, what is required? Your consistent efforts, okay? So 1 year is enough to cover up. 1 year is enough. 365 days you are getting, okay, to study 11th and 12th, and believe me, this span is more than enough, but with some rules or with some important instructions. Which are those? Consistent efforts. Your consistent efforts are essential, okay? So many times we see that some students are more enthusiastic, more energetic at the beginning, but after few weeks, few days, their graph started coming down. It should not happen. You have same energy, okay, or you have to keep the same energy from day one to day last. I know it is a bit difficult, but if you have to achieve something, if you really think that you have not studied in class 11, then believe me children, trust me, you have to do this. This is the only way by which you can cope up with your studies. So continuous effort. Give focus on concept building. As I told you, for competitive exams, concept building is very important. Fine. Our main motto, main target is the NEET examination. We are not focusing properly on the board examination. So for that, you have to focus on concept building. Try to cover up, try to understand each and every concept of 11th as well as 12th. Do not leave a single concept. You can take help of teachers, okay? If you have a very good peer group, and with them also you can distill, but give emphasis on concept building of class 11 as well as 12. Never give up. Yes, this is the one important thing which I want to tell you, that never give up. Try till your last breath, okay? Definitely you will get the result, okay? But never give up. So sometimes you feel that fine, I am not able to understand this. Do anything, ask to your teachers, take help of reference book, discuss among yourself, but try to understand the concept. Never give up anyhow. Fine. Now, the next point, which is very important, which I'm going to discuss, that choose a very good company. Yes, your friends. Okay. Very important point. Now, you were here for last 1 year. You have so many friends. So, the one thing which I wanted to discuss with you, that always you have a good company, okay? So what is the benefit of this? Why you should have good company, and what are the benefits of? First one, you should have such a company which will motivate you, okay? So your friends, okay, your parents, whatever, whichever or with whom you are feeling comfortable, they should motivate you. They should not degrade you in any way. Okay, so they should always motivate you. They will help you to solve your doubts. So you should choose such a company, such friends that can help you to solve your doubts. They can motivate you. Okay, the company that keeps your moral high always. They should not underestimate you in any way. They, your friends or your peer group should always can I say, they should always encourage you, although sometime if you feel still, they can encourage you. They should not discourage you in any way, okay, huh? And the most important thing is choose such company with whom you can have a good discussion. Very important. Sometimes what happened, we also say you first, you try to solve your doubts at your level. So if you have a very good company, very good friends, okay, most of the time you will find the solutions among yourself. You should have a healthy discussion related to studies among you. What happens now, it is a kind of self-encouragement, okay? When you share your doubts, when you discuss your doubts among yourself, okay, we are getting so many new things, yes, huh? So you should have a healthy and good discussion among yourself, which is related to your studies, not related to any another topic, because right now your priority is to complete your studies, so you have to focus on your studies, fine, hmm? So just try to choose a very good company for you. Now, as we are going to start class 12, now with this, what is most important? That is revision of class 11. We know that class 11 syllabus is very vast as compared to class 12. So, revision of class 11. A revision of 11, very very important. Revision of class 11 is very very important, but with this we are not going to hamper your class 12 studies, okay? So we should have such a plan that simultaneously with 12 standard, how we can revise 11 standard also, because if you will not revise class 11 syllabus, you will forget it, yes, sir. And we know that there are many, or the weightage or the syllabus is vast of 11th as compared to 12th standard. So you should have a proper planning. So for that, what we feel that, fine, the Sunday which we are getting, that you should utilize for revision of class 11. We are thinking to give you planning for those Sundays, means which Sunday you will revise which topic of physics, chemistry, biology. If you are able to manage your timetable, it's fine. But at least one day in a week, compulsory, you have to revise class 11th lesson. So if there are suppose 22 lessons in biology, so you can divide those lessons, and one or two lessons you can complete on each Sunday. So accordingly you have to plan. But along with 12th standard, obviously if we are going to start a 12th standard, these 12th standard lessons you have to revise, you have to practice those questions. But with that, don't forget to revise class 11, otherwise you will forget those things, fine, hmm? So there should be separate planning how you are going to revise class 11 syllabus, okay, hmm? With this, don't keep blockages in 12th standard, because 12th standard syllabus is very important. On that syllabus you are going to give your board exam also, hmm? Plus that syllabus, it is very important. So don't keep any blockages in 12th standard. By managing 12th standard, at least once in a week on every Sunday, you have to revise class 11 class 11 syllabus, you have to revise on every Sunday. Then next point which I want to discuss is that spend more time on questions, give more time of question, no picking answers. Yes, this point is very important again, that spend more time on questions. Okay, we all, means most of the students, what they do, they when they sit for solving questions, they read the questions immediately, they flip the page and they see the answer, or some of the students, they try to match the answer. Don't do like this, okay? If you are solving a particular MCQ of any subject, physics, chemistry or biology, use your knowledge, revise the concept, okay, up to most, try to solve by your own. okay, huh? Sometimes it happened the answers which are given in the books, they may be wrong, okay, huh? And if you are having habit of every time flipping the page and then looking for the option, you will not be able to think how to solve the MCQ. So as soon as you see the question, just try to revise, just try to recall the concept. Okay, huh? Take help of reference book, take help of your notes, okay, without seeing option. Yes, huh? So this year you do practice like this, and believe me, this will help you to memorize those concepts. Yes, huh? Now once we come to this point, the next point in this is that always emphasize on quality questions, okay, instead of quantity of question. What type of questions we are solving, that is important. If you are comfortable with some type of questions and if you are solving only that type of question, it will not help you. You have to focus on quality questions. Yes, sir. So for that sake, in the module, some easy level questions are given, some moderate level questions are given. So go stepwise. First you solve easy level questions. Once you feel that fine, concept wise I have revised everything, then you can go for higher level, moderate level question, and at last you go for the HOTS, that is the higher order thinking or some difficult question. If you will start solving difficult level question, because always HOTS, they are based on two or more concepts. So for that, revision of lesson is very important. Concept understanding, it is very important. You have to correlate so many concepts to solve those questions. So you have to start with the easy question. Concept based questions you have to solve. NCRT you have to use properly. As you know that for NEET, NCRT is very important. Each and every line of NCRT, not only for biology, for physics as well as chemistry also. Okay, you have to read NCRT properly. You have to solve previous year's questions. Okay, huh? Just see in what way questions are asked. Yes, huh? And then start solving questions from module. Once those questions will be finished, you will be provided with question banks. Okay, huh? If you will remember or if you will try to memorize each and every question, again, no need to use lot of reference books for this. Okay, huh? So that should be your strategy. So focus on quality questions, not on the quantity of question. Yes, sir. Now for this you have to develop the methodology and you have to understand the concept. You should have a specific methodology for each and every subject. For each and every subject we can't use the same methodology for study. So for biology there should be separate methodology, for physics, chemistry you should have your own methodology, which is the requirement of that subject. Fine. So accordingly you will decide in what way. For example, if I say about biology, the part which is taught today you have to revise from NCRT, you have to revise from your notes and try to solve questions from that part. Okay, so daily you should revise the part which is being taught in the class and try to solve MCQs from that, because if you will start revising the lesson after completion, okay, it will take more time. Okay, so daily you have to revise, and one advantage that you are at home so that you can utilize maximum time for revision. Fine. So if you will keep these things in your mind, believe me, this 1 year, okay, will be enough to complete class 11th and class 12th. Fine. So these are some points which I wanted to be discussed. Fine. So in this way, in this coming year, you have your own plan. For few days, obviously, we are going to send the online lecture. But when you will come in the school also, you have to stick to your timetable. Right now, it is not possible for us to see what are you doing at home. So this is your responsibility, okay, huh? To see what are you doing. Yes, huh? So believe me, children, 11th is gone. But don't think that everything is gone. Nothing is there in our hand. It's not like that, okay? You can only only help yourself. No one other can help you. Although we try to motivate you every time, unless and until you are not accepting this, your mind is not ready to face the challenge, it won't happen. So you are the one, you are the only one who can change your future. You are the only one who are going to work, okay? So if you are dreaming it, if you want to see yourself in the white coat with the stethoscope in the neck, believe or see children, you have to work for this, okay? And 1 year, why I'm emphasizing this, one whole year is there. Hey, students are doing in 6 months also. So 1 year is your hand. Start from day one, okay? Today we are not going to send any another lecture. Today you have to think, you have to plan. Now I have told you in what way you have to prepare yourself. Yes, sir. You are preparing for a competitive exams. For this your studies are very important, okay? So for that planning you do, and for the whole year you have to use the same energy, okay? Never give up. We are always there with you. Whatever doubts you have, you are very free to ask us. Although if you are not able to do your planning, you can ask to us. We will help you to make the plan. But try to give your 100%. Fine. Now with this, or at this note, I will take a leave. I'm not going to take your more time, because 1 day is given to you as a holiday. From tomorrow as it is, we are going to start subject wise lecture. So with this, I want to give you all the best, okay? All the best for upcoming year, okay? I hope that God will give you energy, power, okay, for study. Be positive, never give up, believe on yourself. In any case, just think we are there with you, okay? In any problem, we are there with you to help you, okay? So don't discourage. Always have positive attitude in you, okay? And just do your best, okay? You should have the satisfaction that fine, I have given my best performance, okay? So with this, I'll take a note here, okay? At this note, I'll take a leave, okay? All the very best for this upcoming year, and I want every student to be sincere from tomorrow, regular, in touch. Although there is a doubt session, all students should remain present. Last week we were observing, whenever doubt session was being conducted, hardly 10 to 15 students were there. This should not be happening. If students are not there for doubt session, we have authority to remove you from the group. All students should be present day for doubt session. You have to watch the video lecture on the time. You know what happens if you miss a single day also. Last year you have paid for this. Yes, sir. You know what happened when you miss a single lecture also. Yes, sir. So this year you can't miss. This year you have to start watching lectures on the given time itself. Fine. So doubt session you have to attempt. Be sincere in your work. All students must remain present for the doubt session. I'm telling this again and again, because I'm observing that students are not attending the doubt session. There is no problem to attend the doubt session. If you have any problem, you have to discuss with the subject teacher before, okay? Whatever work will be given by subject teacher, that you have to complete on time. You are at home, it doesn't mean that you are enjoying the holidays. No, we are not given you any holiday. Because of this pandemic, you are not able to come in the school, so we are sending you the online lecture. We are taking the doubt session either on Google Meet or Zoom, whatever. So whatever the subject teachers will ask you, that you have to do. The sheet or the practice sheet, any exercise which is given to you, that you have to solve compulsory without any excuse, okay? You have to join the doubt session class, okay, without a fail. Yes, sir. So I hope everyone will understand. Everyone will try to do this. Yes, sir. So all the very best for this upcoming year. Do well. All the very best. God will bless you always. Thank you so much.